Let us draw two lines or a pair of lines. Well, there can be a lot of ways of drawing two lines. Some of them are drawn here on the board. So, there can be a lot of ways. But, if I extend them, there are only two possibilities. Either the lines will meet or they will not meet. So, although there are a lot of ways of drawing these lines, but there are only two possibilities if we extend them. Either they meet or they do not meet. So we see that these two lines, they meet at this point. Let's call this point as point O. These two lines meet at this point, point O, and even these two lines meet at this point. This point where these lines meet is called the common point. Why common point? Because it is common to both the lines. So this point O is on this red line as well as on this blue line. So this point is common to both the lines. So it is called the common point. In this case also, point O is the common point, and in this case, point O is the common point. So these three pairs of line that meet at a common point are called intersecting lines. So the lines which meet at a common point are called intersecting lines. These lines could meet each other if they are extended or even without extending. No matter whether they meet without extending or after extending, the lines are called intersecting lines. And the common point where these lines meet is called the point of intersection. So O is the point of intersection in each of the three cases. So point O is the point of intersection of these two lines. It is the common point of the two lines. And these lines which do not meet are called non-intersecting lines. So they do not meet at any point. No matter how much ever you extend them in any direction, they will never meet. And such lines are called non-intersecting lines. Now, can you think of some examples of non-intersecting lines from your daily life? Well, have you seen a ladder? These two sides of the ladder, this side and this side, if we consider these two sides as two lines, then these are two non-intersecting lines. They will never meet. No matter how long or how small the ladder is, these lines never meet. These are railway tracks. So we consider these to be two lines. Again, these two lines never meet or intersect each other. So these are non-intersecting lines. Now let us draw three lines. So there could be many ways of drawing three lines. These three lines do not meet. These three lines meet at a point. In this case, this line intersects the other two lines. In this case also, this line intersects the other two lines. So let us first concentrate on these two cases. In each of the two cases, one line intersects the other two line, and such a line is called a transversal. Transversal. So a transversal is a line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points. So we see that line P intersects line M and line N. So line P is a transversal in this case. Note that these lines, which a transversal intersects, could be intersecting lines or they could be non-intersecting lines. In any case, P is called the transversal. So now, if we consider this ladder again, each step of the ladder is a transversal. It intersects the sides of the ladder. So T is the transversal. If we consider these railway tracks, T is the transversal. In these two cases, these lines are non-intersecting. But if we consider this swing, these are two supports of the swing. And this T is the transversal. So T is the transversal of these intersecting lines here. So a transversal intersects two or more lines at distinct points. So now, can you tell me whether M is a transversal or not? Well, we see that M intersects line P. And M also intersects line N. So M is a line which intersects two lines. Hence, M is a transversal. So, the answer is yes. M is a transversal. Is P a transversal? We see that P intersects M and N. But recall the definition of a transversal. A transversal is a line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points. P intersects M and N at the same point. So this point is common to P, M and N. P does not intersect M and N at distinct points. So P is not a transversal. Then what are such lines called? Such lines are called concurrent lines. Concurrent lines. So if three or more lines intersect at a point, then those lines are called concurrent lines. In this case, P, M and N intersect at this point. So these three are concurrent lines. P, M, N and R intersect at this point. So these four are concurrent lines. So concurrent lines are the lines which intersect at a point. Three or more lines which intersect at a point.